Microsoft has just announced a series of autonomous agents. Are you ready to meet your new crew? Let's dive in and explore the time and expense agent together. For project teams, endless hours are wasted capturing expenses and time entries, and for managers, approving those time entries. We're transforming that. In this live demo, we'll go through the three scenarios the agent helps with, starting with lightening the expense load. To set the agent up, I start in feature management. All I did was search for the time and expense agent and click enable. Now, our first scenario is generating expenses for employees. To use this portion of the agent, we'll start by setting some parameters. On screen, we can see that the expense agent is activated and we can choose the frequency we want it to run at. If we choose weekly, we can choose which days of the week we want the agent to run. But in this case, we're just going to choose for it to run daily. And then we can choose whether we want the agent to group reports by project or by trip. In this case, we're going to say by trip. I'm in an employee's Outlook account, and all I need to do to use the agent is find a receipt and go ahead and send it to a shared inbox. So in this case, we're going to attach a recent parking receipt and send it on. Then the agent is going to pick it up and process it for me as an expense. I can carry on with my day-to-day tasks, and when it's ready for me to review, I'm going to get a notification in Teams. So if we let time move forward a little bit, we'll see. Yep, there it is. There's that notification. And if I come in and click on it, I can see that the agent has taken the receipt and pulled all the key information out about it. It's gone ahead and identified the trip that it's part of, the dates that it's on, what the actual expense is, and it's ready for me to approve. All I need to do is click send for approval, and it will send it off to my manager. Whether I'm submitting one receipt or many, it can process them all for me, meaning I don't need to do any more manual processing of expenses. The next scenario that the agent supports is making it significantly easier to generate time entries. So again, to begin with, we'll manage the setup. I'm in Teams here, and as an individual employee, I type in Copilot user preferences for the time entry agent, and it's going to bring up this preferences box. The first question it's asking is, do I want Copilot to create draft time entries for me based on my project assignments or bookings? Yes, absolutely. Then, do I want it to go ahead and generate comments for each entry using the information from Dynamics 365 Project Operations? Yep, I'd love that. And finally, do I want it to look into my Outlook calendar and see what information is in there for my activities and incorporate that into the comments? Yep, that sounds good to me. Finally, I just need to choose my time zone. And the reason I'm doing this is because depending on my time zone, it's going to send me notifications at 5 p.m. wherever I'm based with my entries for the day. The reason it does this is that we know from customers that if individuals don't create their entries day of, they struggle to remember the detail of what they were doing that day. So by receiving this daily prompt at 5 p.m. in their time zone, it's fresh in their mind. My time zone's good, so I'm going to go ahead and click Save Preferences. And my individual preferences are ready for the agent. So now let's see us using it in real life. Time passes, and at the end of the day at 5 p.m., we'll get a notification from the agent. And there we go. There's the notification. What we can see is it's gone ahead and pulled in all of the activities for the week. Now, if I had submitted my entries for the previous days in the week, it would only show me the activities for my current day. But because I haven't, it's showing me all of the previous days so I can manage those as well. And what we can see for today, it's pulled in the project name and the tasks, and it's generated those comments using a combination of Dynamics 365 Project Operations and Outlook. Now I can go in and make any changes that I want. In this case, I'm going to add a little bit more information. Then I can go ahead and click Submit. And the time entry has been completed for me. I haven't had to do any work here. All the information was correlated for me. When it was ready, I review it and submit it to my manager, and I can get back to focusing on my other work. Now, the final scenario that the agent supports is approving those time entries. So again, how do we set that up? For this final scenario, just like the first one, we're setting rules that apply to all employees who interact with the approval agent. So in this case, the first thing we want to do is go ahead and upload an approval policy. Now, if a business doesn't have an approval policy, they can use the sample template that we provide. And in this case, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to upload the policy that we've generated specific for our business's rules. We just go ahead and click Save. And now we can go ahead and see what it looks like in real life. So if we go to Projects, we can now see as an employee that the approvals agent has appeared. Here we can see on screen all the entries that have been completed by members of my team. Now, a couple things have happened. It's gone ahead and it's reviewed each entry and compared it to the policy. If it's compliant with the policy, it gets a ready for approval status. And if it's not, we can see here the reason why it's not compliant. Now, there's two ways that this agent is set up. The first option is that it's just classifying these entries. But what we can also do is have it manage the entries, and where they're compliant, it can auto-approve them. If we come back into settings, we can see where that's set up. We can see here on the right-hand side for mode, we've just got it set up as classified. Now we know in reality, so many businesses today are just manually bulk approving time entries because they have hundreds to review on a weekly basis. But we want our customers to be comfortable. So what we've done is given the option to either have the system just classify, then the individuals can approve them, or go ahead and auto approve if they're comfortable with that. So if we come back to approvals agent, what we can do in this case where we have it set as classify is we can filter by the status, choose the ones that are ready for approval and just approve those. And then the ones that need review, we can push back to our team members so that they can make the necessary changes. And just like that, we've seen how the agent has been able to support the approvals process, saving significant amount of times having to review hundreds of entries on a weekly basis. I've just shown you how the time and expense agent is going to save significant amounts of time for your team every single week by helping to create those expense entries and create and approve time entries. I can't wait to see what you do with it.